Hey guys, what's up? It's Charlie here, and today we're going to be looking at what if you were buried alive? I'm sure none of us would ever want to actually be in this situation, and some of us may have even had nightmares about this, or it may be our phobias. But it's important you know this stuff, as some people really have been buried alive. Today we're going to learn about those people and also learn how long you could survive and how to survive if you're ever buried alive. But before that happens, why not subscribe and press the notification bell too. So first off, pretty important question, how long could you survive? Well, believe it or not, it actually doesn't depend so much about you. Really, it all comes down to the coffin itself. Basically, the bigger the coffin is or the smaller you are, the longer you'll survive. That's because the less space you take up means more room for oxygen. There will be a very fastly depleting oxygen supply in the coffin you're in. But the moment that oxygen goes away, then you begin to pass away. Now, because this has never been tested, scientists aren't exactly sure how long a regular healthy person would survive in a normal sized coffin. One scientist said a regular guy would have around 10 minutes to an hour, while another scientist was more generous and said a regular person would have around 6 to 36 hours. But I don't recommend testing it out in your own backyard experiments. If you happen to be a swimmer or marathon runner, then good for you. You likely have a very good lung capacity and will be able to hold your breath for a few extra minutes. Or maybe if you're magician David Blaine, you could hold your breath for 17 minutes. This is actually a stunt he did on the Oprah Winfrey Show. The average coffin measures around 85 by 30 by 20 inches. This gives it a total volume of around 890 liters. The average human body is around 70 liters. So this gives us quite a bit of air. But every 2 minutes, a human consumes a liter of oxygen. So it would take about 6 hours before all of the oxygen in the coffin was consumed. But the bad news is you likely wouldn't be able to get out even if you could hold your breath. The saying 6 feet under doesn't just sound cool in gangster movies, it's actually how deep coffins are buried. This means if you broke the wood of the coffin, then you'd be buried by a landslide of dirt. This would likely crush you and take you out within a few seconds. An avalanche of snow could easily crush somebody within a few minutes. But dirt is even heavier, so don't expect to make it out alive. Also, dirt would go into your mouth and nostrils and clog up your airways, so you couldn't breathe. But if you didn't break the coffin, then how would you pass? Well, actually, you'd pass a lot more peacefully. Carbon dioxide would build up, and this would knock you out. Then, while you would be in a coma, your heart would stop, and then so would the rest of your body. But let's be a bit more positive for a minute, and look at how you could survive. You may think if you were trapped in a wooden box 6 feet underground, there would be no way out. But there is actually a way to get out, and it involves a few steps. The first thing you have to do is calm down. Nobody would blame you for being stressed out over getting buried alive. But one thing you do have to do is stop any panic attacks which may be happening. It may sound kind of corny, but breathing exercises can help you do this very quickly and will help to conserve air. The next thing you need to do is have a look around in your coffin. It's likely not very big, so don't worry, it won't take too long. You should check your pockets for any tools or instruments that could be useful. Most people are usually buried wearing a belt, and a belt buckle could be very useful here. Cufflinks or steel-toed shoes could also be very helpful. And obviously the ultimate item to have is a cell phone. Remember, even if you don't have a signal underground, many emergency numbers like 911 will actually be picked up by the nearest cell tower. Even if your phone doesn't have any credit or a service plan, don't worry, you'll still be able to get through. In 2017, a businessman who was buried alive by Russian gangsters used his cell phone to get out. That's right, this actually happened to Kikmet Salvel, who was $400,000 in debt to the Russian mob. The mobsters didn't take his cell phone, however, and he was able to call his brother Ismail, who came to his rescue. And in Japan, it's actually a popular practice to be buried with a phone in case you're ever buried alive. But if you don't have a phone, the next thing you can do is resort to a more primitive way of communicating. That is by using Morse code. You can start banging the SOS Morse code signal on your coffin with your fist. All you need to do is 3 quick taps. Chances are somebody may be walking by and hear a banging coming from underground. In the 19th century, this actually did work for a young woman named Philomele Jonetre. She had been buried alive and was able to be dug back out after people heard her banging on her grave. She did pass away pretty much right after, but hey, at least she got out. Another thing you need to do is take very slow, deep breaths. Taking lots of short breaths will actually make you need more air. and that will just waste very precious minutes while you're underneath the ground. Now, I know I said before that if you try and dig yourself out, you may be crushed by dirt, but it could be better than accepting your certain fate by just remaining in the coffin. After all, in 2013, a Brazilian man actually dug him out of a very shallow grave. The way to protect your airways from dirt getting into it is by covering it with an item of clothing. But one thing you really have to hope for, and you can't control this, is good weather. That's not for having a celebratory barbecue after breaking out. Instead, it's because soil becomes very dense when it's wet. And if the soil gets wet, it will be nearly impossible to dig through. But if you guys are really concerned about this, maybe take some precautions with you when you go to the afterlife. If you know you're about to pass away soon, then maybe tell relatives to put a cell phone and a torch in your grave. And if you're $400,000 in debt to the Russian mob, always keep a cell phone on your person. If you ever need rescuing, just give me a call. But now let's look at some people in history who were actually buried alive. In 1822, a 40-year-old German shoemaker was buried alive. But during his funeral, the family got a very surprising shock when they heard banging from the grave. They removed all the earth and got the coffin up as soon as possible. In 1915, a 30-year-old from South Carolina named Essie Dunbar had a fit. Everyone had thought she had passed on. But remember, in 1915, doctors weren't exactly as good as they are today. She was put in a coffin, put underground, but then her sister said she wanted to see her one last time. So they took the coffin back up and opened the lid. Then, very creepily, Essie sat up and smiled at everyone around her. Amazingly, she then went on to live for another 50 years. Of course, I've already briefly mentioned Philomele Jonetre. This actually happened all the way back in 1864 in France. She'd been put in her coffin, put underground, and then 16 hours later, a priest heard something strange. He could hear a banging from underground, so immediately got the coffin dug up. Philomele was able to survive for 16 hours underground. But as I said, she did pass away pretty much right after that, but at least she got out. And finally, we have another case of this happening in France in 1937. A man named Angelo Hays had fallen off his motorbike and hit his head on a brick wall. Everyone, including the doctors, thought he'd passed on. But the local insurance company had some questions they needed to ask before paying the family any money. So 2 days after the funeral, his body had to be taken back up. As they did that, they found out he was actually alive and had just been in a deep coma. So next time you guys complain about how bad insurance companies are, remember, they saved this guy's life. I mean, they were doing this to try and pay a family less, but still. So guys, vote in the poll if you're going to ask your relatives to bury you with a phone or not. I thought the idea was pretty wacky, but after hearing these stories, maybe it's not such a bad idea. If you guys want some more amazing videos, check out my second channel. There'll be a link to that coming up on screen in a moment. But as always, thank you guys for watching. Check out some more videos on screen right now. Leave a like if you enjoyed, and if you haven't already, what are you waiting for? Subscribe to Top 10s.